the paper, the newspaper, at the same time I was there, David Simon was there, Laura Lippman was there, and Dan Vesperman was there. And the irony was the sort of like the honchos at the newspaper really didn't like to see us doing well as fiction writers, because that meant like, oh, you're neglecting your other work. I guess to answer your question, is there something in the water? Well, we're all friends. We're all supportive. We all went to the same parties. We encouraged each other. We complimented each other on our work. And we also like to read good books.
Yeah.
So the protagonist in my mystery series, which is set in 1920s India, is a woman called Praveen Mystery. And she is, in my novel, she's the city's first woman lawyer. And I wanted to have a heroine who could come back in future books and have a reason to be involved in, you know, situations with corruption and theft and death. And what better than a lawyer, right? And the reality was there were few early women lawyers in India. So I decided to set my protagonist in the very early 1920s when they were close to being able to argue a case, but not allowed to, because I wanted to show that systemic discrimination and also show how my heroine triumphs over that. Yeah, the moment that I learned from one of my historian friends in Mumbai that the Prince of Wales, Edward VIII, visited India for 4 months in 1921 to 22, and there was this huge riot that broke out after his arrival in Bombay. The moment I heard that, I knew that was going to be the plot for the book. It's just not talked about a whole lot. And it really shows that the British were hoping for something to happen with the visit. They were hoping for people to fall in love with royalty again, kind of the way we all do when there's a royal wedding. You know, we just get this good feeling, and they thought that was going to happen because it happens all the time when you know, British royalty visited around the UK and other countries. But what was happening is Mahatma Gandhi was a lawyer at the time, and he was building his freedom movement like crazy in Bombay. And so he held a rally to contradict the arrival of the prince the same day. And what happened was all these fired up young men from that rally crossed paths with people who had been celebrating the prince's arrival. And so there was all this mayhem. And it was one of the rare situations where Hindus and Muslims aligned together in a riot. And then the other side were Anglo-Indians and Parsis, who are Zoroastrians born in India. That's the ethnic background of my heroine. And also people of European heritage.
And when are you going to come to Oxford?
Oh, I'm coming to Oxford this coming Saturday.
Oh, you are? 14th.
Yeah, I'm going to Oxford, which is one of my favorite places in Maryland. I'm having a signing at Mystery Loves Company on South Morris Street. I'm going to be on the lawn. It's from 12 to 2, and I just want to tell folks it's absolutely masked. I'm going to be double masked, and we're not having people sitting on chairs together. It's sort of going to be a meet and greet, and I'll have extra masks, but please bring your own mask if you can.